We thank you for our protection. We thank you for our provision. We thank you for being our Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. You are seated in the presence of the Lord. This morning, we are looking at a step of the fire from Deuteronomy. We can talk about the Leviticus chapter 6, we will be reading verse 12 and verse 13. Leviticus chapter 6, we will be reading verse 12 and verse 13. And the fire upon the altar shall be burning in it. It shall not be put out. The priest shall burn wood on it every morning, and lay the burnt offering in order upon it, and shall burn thereon the fat of the peace offering. And the fire shall ever be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out. Praise the Lord. Now, Christianity without anointing is religion. If you are a Christian and you don't walk in the power of anointing, you are practicing religion. And that's what we need to understand, that even if you gave your life to Jesus Christ, you are giving Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is so important in the life of everyone. This time, in our celebration, we need to understand Jesus Christ died in my life and in our life. He resurrected. The essence of his death is to make sure that his fire is being in our hearts. Because that was compels you to do the right thing you're supposed to do. The fire of God is given so much in our life and in our life. In order to succeed in this life of great challenges, we need it. I told you earlier in some of my discussion that people thought that Holy Ghost is just, people say it's a flame, people say it's your power. It's from God's head, and it has its own way. He's the one that is representing everything that I created in this world. Even when we are selling the light, it's always the light. If you remember, Jesus Christ was born. He was anointed, and he was called the anointed and anointed one. What made Jesus Christ different from other prophets is the anointing. It's not that other people were called the anointing, but that anointing that made Jesus effective. Christ made Jesus effective. Without that Christ being the anointing, Jesus Christ is nothing. Praise the Lord. You know that Jesus Christ is very answer. Those things have a significant name. That's the Christ, the fire that made the difference.
Praise the Lord.
Now, what we are trying to show here is that this person was given to Moses how to offer sacrifice in the altar of God. And Bible said that here, there was fire in the altar of God continually. That's why he told that. Can never will go Ghost. It's very, very important. It's the focus of your heart. It's one that speaks in your heart. It's the director. It's the one that scrutinizes your heart. What comes in and what goes out. It's one that makes a decision if you can allow it. It's the fire in your heart. That's what I say. Keep on the fire burning in my heart. Do you think that I want to put wood and gravestone in your heart and light it to match it? No. It is the light of Holy Ghost, the fire of Holy Ghost, that light it in your heart. Why do you think the person is the seal of my father's house? Shall do what? Have what is it that exactly that is consuming you? What is it that you are so serious about? And you discover that Satan are doing everything possible to take away the fire in our life. I cannot be a wedding Christian. You cannot if there is no power of Holy Ghost in your heart. Because we need to allow it. We need to take away the Holy Ghost and allow him to go to the person of us. And that's why we don't have faith in every area of our life. And that's why we can be successful in every area of our life. He said, fire was ignited in the altar of your heart. The moment you are filled with Holy Ghost, that sanctifying fire that makes you more than a man. Divine energy is now being stirred in you. Sanctify fire. That's why, if you look at the Bible, Isaiah was still complaining of now working for the Lord. And when the Lord spoke, he said, I am not unbelief. How can I come and speak to the same people? If you are a man of God, you are still doing the same thing that we. How can I speak to them? But he said, the Lord went to the altar and take a call of battle by fire. And touch the leaves. There's a fire that is being on in the altar. I said, now you are pleased. He said, now you can serve me. And the Lord said, I have to send someone. He said, Lord, you can do what? Send me. All along, he had been walking, he had been prophesying, he had been doing so many things, but he never affected me. All along, he had been mingled in society. He couldn't be able to influence life or to win the power and the fire from the altar from Jesus Christ. And when the Holy Ghost comes to your heart, he sanctifies whatever comes to your life. He sanctifies the word you speak. He sanctifies the way you talk, the way you act. What you do, that is the power of the Holy Ghost. Don't take Holy Ghost as just a power. It is more than you can think about. It is more than going to make you what you may not be able to think that you are going to make life. He can promise you, he's the one that shows you the pathway, he's the one that's still active today. You need to keep the flame in your heart. If the flame cannot be in my heart, that's when there will be a lot of problems. Because the only one that empowers you for any change is the only one that empowers you to withstand situations, faults of the life, comforts of the life. Everything that comes in this life is one that stood with you and makes you to be able to overcome. Praise the Lord. So it is very, very important as a child of God. He gives you room to live a good life. When we are preaching the gospel, what we are going to preach to people. Nobody talking about Jesus. He's going to relate to them with the light and the fire of the Lord that dwells in your heart. At the moment that the fire is still on your heart, you will not be able to say there are no people fighting against each other.
That's fine.
And if the fire is not there, it is impossible. It's not about when you protect yourself because of it. It's about when there's a fire that is in you. You conquer Satan. You conquer all the threats and that of enemy. It is the fire that gives you all. You are in a room, all of a sudden, all is switched. There are no way the light will be on. You may even go to speak the power of the Holy Ghost. You will light up the light in your heart. And it takes over your heart. If it will touch you, people can ask some people, because when they pray the Holy Ghost, in good time, they look at what they're coming. You charge your inner man. You make your inner man charge. You will charge him with boldness. You will never be afraid. That is language that is only dangerous to hear, but Satan cannot be able to hear it. He couldn't be able to understand it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So it is very important as a child of God, it's a gift. Now, John Wesley says on this day, he said, praise the Lord, keep their fire burning upon, keep their fire burning upon the altar of my heart. Stir up the gift in me. And that's what he tells God every day. Keep their fire burning on the altar of my heart. That's your wisdom. He said, and stir up the gift in you. And until he died, he was called evangelist with a burning fire. and powerful in him. Praise the Lord. We need to allow the fire to penetrate more perpetually in our hearts. Let it more perpetually in our hearts, continually in our hearts, without breach in our hearts. We need to allow it. This time we're talking about Jesus Christ's risen. This is the time we need to pray. And God, Jesus is so wonderful that he cannot leave his disciples. I can never leave you as an orphan. Would that Holy Ghost be an orphan? Because they will walk with that fire. And that's why I told them that if he anointed the seal of fire, like Joseph 17:27. Everything that I have taught you, if the anointing will remind you, it's not anointing of oil, only oil. If Holy Spirit is in your life, he will be the reminder of everything I taught you about me. Everything he has spoken of his Father, spoken of himself, spoken of Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost will be the reminder. Is the one that first seen on earth, is the one that comes to him on earth. That's why Holy Spirit is very, very important. Don't live life without Holy Spirit. Don't do anything without a fire. In Old Testament, before they go to war, they will ask God, should we go? They say, no. Don't go. David can say, go, or should we? There's a testimony I share when I was traveling because I'm barren now. I told him, I can't remember the area we are passing, but it's not towards me. Lord opened my eyes. You know, the Lord opened my eyes. I saw great men inside the whole bush. People filled the whole bush, but they're not ordinary people. As for a person by the room, they have all of them more than 1,000. As I was saying, I told the person that I was driving, I said, I never experienced this in the house since my last job to see. I see great men inside the bush. They are not men, they are angels, they are soldiers. Say, boss, go, we are with you. They just, you know how they started to say, go. Before I leave, the next one is up there. God opened my eyes. Everywhere I was lying down, we are filled with green. I woke up to a God, they don't know who God is going to pray. Green everywhere. You look at someone that went inside the bush and going to drop off the leaves. Person run as a green light. And that's why you will tell how to do it without the Ghost. You can't survive, you can't believe it. He will show you, he said, in the very end from the beginning, he tells you what to go and not what to go. I remember even that time when I told my father, I said, there's a man that I come for with needles. The man, if you want to overtake him, he will block us. There are almost 4 cars. They are right faster than us. Before we can reach where they are going, how can I know which I didn't have to say? Because of that, how can I know that as a pastor, I can't be able to define it? Other people are going, some people are coming down, how is that which I can't be able to say? You don't think that you are so you are too smart? No! You ask God before doing anything. What will ask? Let me tell you one thing. When you pray, Holy Ghost comes. Some people, they manifest to see, I was in the dream. I saw, I see Jesus. The person that came is Holy Ghost, but he came before first from Jesus. Because he cannot be separated from Jesus. Jesus cannot be separated from God. Holy Ghost cannot be separated from them. He manifests himself because he's the only one that is present on the earth. When Jesus wants to show himself, the person that will come, Holy Ghost, but he lose the place from Jesus because they are not separated. Can anyone understand what I'm saying now? God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost, they are one. But the only one person that is actually walking today, he will die, is Holy Ghost. You can't see Jesus Christ again. His rest is sitting at the throne as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. But God will not have any time again. Holy Ghost is the one that is walking 24 hours. That's why God is asking you, allow Holy Ghost. Anytime you say, I am walking at the throne of your heart, Holy Ghost is the one that has sent. Because the one that can go anywhere that enter, Holy Ghost can enter there. Anywhere in the air, God is everywhere because Holy Ghost is God in be set ahead. See, Holy Ghost is not released from Godhead. Jesus Christ is not that his son is smaller. They are equal. They are the same thing. They can move without any father. They have their own will. That's why for some people look at the Holy Ghost, Jesus Christ is the Son, yes. Son down. Holy Ghost is just the power down, down. He said, man, they are the same thing. That is why the Holy Ghost is the one that proceeds out of God. What comes out of God is God himself. What that comes out of God is God himself. About the Jesus Christ is in the union of God. He didn't allow anyone to see or the way he wanted to make him as a sacrificial lamb. After this whole thing, he made his soul manifest. And today, he said, if this is God, everything you see about me, everything you talk about God, goes in Jesus Christ and say. So if you want to talk about God, you talk about Jesus. Everything you say, God, not expect an advice where you're going to see this is a lie, don't want this throne. The verses of the Bible says, Behold, I saw one throne. The only one that stayed there is the righteous one. The one that sacrificed his life on the cross of war. Don't expect that the same is the chairman, vice chairman, secretary. Then he said, lie. That one said, you only see Jesus Christ as the King, the Lord of the Lord. So God has said that I have to give this here. The one being for me, my wife. Is he alive? The last day is only one God here. But they cannot, that's why God made it possible. All over the whole world, when they are talking about Jesus, Holy Ghost is present. Let's look at all of Jesus. God is alive. Holy Ghost will go anywhere. As you are sitting there now, you are going to die here. He said, Holy Ghost is walking in all of you that is happening. Walking here, walking here. And he said that. You will stand here, proceed this side, from this side to this side, from this side to the other side, continue walking and walking and walking and walking. If they are leaders, that's why you see when that used to say, God will now move around and touch the life of people. And he's the one that keeps his light in your hearts. If you will succeed in your education, succeed in your marriage, succeed in your job, succeed in everything, allow Holy Ghost to take over. People always will pursue problems and problems, but the major thing they needed to do, they can't do it. The life we are going to lead is very, very important. And that's what we came here to advise you to do. 2 Peter chapter 2, 6 to 8. And the torment of the city of Sodom and Gomorrah, into ashes, condemned them with all overthrowing them at example of all those that after should live ungodly. And delivered just not, blessed with the tilted of possession of the wicked. I will read it as the final verses. For the righteous man dwelleth among them, in seeing and hearing, best is righteous soul from day to day with their unlawful deed. Now, the Bible says that the love righteous soul was best, and the fire of the soul has taken away as it is confined to observe the lawlessness and wickedness ways of people of the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. And the Bible says it so easy. His soul got to weigh down. He got to get into trouble. When you go to see the place of the world, people are living. There's a place you will live. There's a people you will live with the spiritual being who got to wear and wear down. You've got to feel pain that you don't want to stay again. That's what God is trying to prevent us here. And it's very, very important for you. What kind of magazine are you reading? You think that you need anything you see? Some of us go to you from where they show you sexual destiny. You read it, you are bringing the spirit, you are weighing down the fire of Holy Ghost in your heart. Your conversation is very important. I remember many years ago, the world where I did this on the chat, I was in the local board of the post office. So that place is a free newspaper. So as I was doing the newspaper, one guy was looking at one of the things. I can see. He was busy looking at this magazine. He wanted to buy you have seen the eyes of everybody. So I prepared a sister to see. I'm very young that I can propose later. So I do. The minute the girl look at that, nobody's watching, you go to the vendor, pay the money, collect the money. Everything that written there is nonsense. Pictures they are having. As you're moving, that's the only thing that comes to your heart. And what does he do? He now weighs down the fire of Holy Ghost in you. The video you watch, the movies you watch, is very, very important. What you listen to is very, very important. Now this, as you say, the fire of the Lord in your heart will go down. And that person that I'm trying to do. We say that faith coming by fear, you probably coming by hearing. You may not be afraid when you discover, unless you don't really understand yourself as the one that can go through. There's something I was discussing yesterday, and the point of my speech just become feel so bitter and bad. I want to say, God, forgive me, I want to say, I'm talking. I think we're in the morning and discussion because we have Holy Ghost in you. There are things you will talk, Holy Ghost will remind you, you will see. Because the Bible says the joy of the Lord is for us. Who is the joy? Holy Ghost in you is your strength. You need your life again. Holy Ghost is the joy of the Lord. And when the joy, that's what the Bible says, the kingdom of God is now. He said, righteousness, peace, and holy. And when you do something wrong, Holy Ghost will remind you you have brought something that is a point into your heart. Some of people are good in their head, and still they are nagging and shouting and fighting. Because they don't have Holy Ghost, they will not fight. People that don't say anything in their life, Holy Ghost is there in their life, there's no more in their life. But as a child of God that goes to God every day, there are things you will do to be very sick of forgiving you. Because you know you have God that bless you. You must remember that you have God. People only listen with their head, they are right. But they never understand because they have never been convicted by Holy Ghost. It's the only way to give Holy Ghost chance to convict you of the wrong and the right. Because that's the only thing that keeps you flame in the corner of your heart. I pray that God will strengthen us today in Jesus' name. Don't allow anything to bring down your spirituality. To bring down the anointing that is upon your heart. If you read 1 Timothy chapter 2, 2 Timothy chapter 1, sorry, verse 6, there's something the Lord said here. He said, that we will be fanning our fire. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 6. He said here, wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou shalt stir up the gift of God, which is in thee, by putting all my your hand. 1 Timothy chapter 1, 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 6. But if you read it in our translation, it's talking about fanning the fire of the Lord in your life. How do you fan it? You always speak in tongues. I discovered that this is something very, very poor people speak in tongues. If anybody speaks in tongues, they look at each other and what is it talking about? And until you open up your heart that you want it. No one wants someone, you want to speak to someone. You may not be able to start to sing and pray, but you may be driving your car and speaking in tongues going your way. God has said that you will hear what God will say, I will speak like another person. That is a tongue. In a new tongue. And I'm knowing that as you're speaking, you yourself know what you're talking about. Nobody else is really talking about. We have to look at the scripture of the Bible. Allow Holy Ghost to live in your life. Stop doubting God. When you don't mind God is talking to that, when you doubt God's word, you are doubting from God again, and you can call His hand and you step out. Because the person that are going to do the word is Holy Ghost. And that's what I have to say, don't speak against Holy Ghost. Everyone else will be forgiven. But the word speaking against Holy Ghost can never be. Because it dwells in you, it's God in you, it's divine in your heart. Hey, I was in dream. They wanted to kill me. Which kind of thing? You don't want it. I don't know how it happened. I tell you that. Holy Ghost. I was so that the thing pushed me. You don't want it. I didn't think for Holy Ghost. I was in, I had a ring. Holy Ghost. What happened? I saw myself in the heart of the soul. I used the soul again. Holy Ghost, make everything possible for you, even in my challenges are we in every place of our life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.